Welcome here to Midnight Motorsports. Running at Richmond tonight, 115 laps. Should be a pretty good race. We've been watching them do a little bit of practicing here out on the track, turning some pretty good times. This is one of them tricky tracks. Your small oval, I believe it's only a mile or maybe a little bit less than a mile. I don't recall. But it should be a pretty decent race. It's kind of like a D-shaped oval. Turns are a little tight with these trucks, but they are a lot of fun out here to run on these. Joining me in the booth here tonight, Roger Wagner. Welcome, Roger, and good to have you, buddy.
Well, I appreciate it. Thanks for having me here again. I love to come work in the booth with you, especially on these Sunday night races, these trucks at the Midnight Motorsports Group with the open setups they got here. Yeah, they're here at Richmond tonight. Three-quarter mile, a D-shaped oval. Really tricky track, good and slick. They got the humidity up a little bit tonight. It's going to be a lot of fun. It's going to be like driving on ice for these guys. A lot of fun. We're seeing some quick times. Some guys have done some mock Q runs, and you and I actually got to get out there and run a few laps. So it was kind of fun.
Yeah, and I believe you turned in a P1 time.
Yeah, like I told you then, anybody can be fast for one lap. But but a 20.54 is a pretty quick lap anywhere you go with any group you race. So 20.54 is not too bad. With this group, the 6s and 7s in qualifying, the low 6s and 7s, that'll fill up the field for the most part for the guys that want to really go out and try, the guys that just want to kind of hang in the back. I mean, they got 115 laps, short little track like this. That's a long time here, and you really can get dizzy running around a little place like this for that long. So some of these guys want to start in the back and just kind of relax and take their time, so you won't see a real fast time from some of these guys. But this place is tricky. It's a lot of fun. These guys should have a good time racing here. It'll be a hell of a show.
Roger that. Well, I'm looking forward to it. Coming down to 11 and a half minutes here until they get ready to qualify. So, yeah, I agree with you. It should be a pretty good show out here tonight for these guys.
Yeah, sorry, I'm chatting with a guy that I'm kind of helping him work on the setup, and now he's jumped up to the number 2 spot on the board there. He's finding it.
Oh boy. And that's what it takes out here. Take a look at the, oh yeah, Timothy up there too, the second position.
Yeah, I came in tonight giving him a pretty hard time about at least 2 or 3 cautions out of him, and I'm trying to help him get a little quicker and a little more consistent here. It looks like it's working out for him.
Drivers out on the track tonight, so hopefully they can get through this 115 lapper here without too many cautions. But I think we're kind of prepared for maybe an extra caution or two in here until they start getting settled in and realize just how slick this track is.
Yeah, it's pretty slick, especially coming up off the corners, because you're trying to get all that power down It's really tough, but these guys, they'll figure it out pretty fast. I see Perry Snelson made it in, so there's another really fast driver. Waiting for him to get unloaded and get out on the track, see what kind of times he can put up. But I mean, you see it, 54, 59, 61, 62, 69, that's the top 5 trucks. It's going to be like that, and all night long it's going to be 3 or 4 trucks really close until somebody gets something on a long run maybe that really holds on, and then that person will start to scoot away from the field. Otherwise, it's going to be a really tight race.
Yeah, I was watching David Lowe there a few minutes ago, and I definitely wanted to kind of watch for him. Boy, he likes to sneak in there and steal the win from him, We've had some fast guys out here. Brandon Thomas, definitely fast. Steven Pearson, definitely fast. So, one to kind of watch for right in the mix of that. David Lowe, I believe he could maybe sneak in here and get this win tonight.
Yeah, Pearson picked up the win here last week, and he's one of the leaders over at Raw Power Motorsports. So, kind of expect to see him run up front. Brandon Thomas, always really fast. Sometimes he races pretty good. Sometimes he kind of flounders a little bit. Just kind of depends. If he gets off to a good start, he'll be good. But David Lowe, over here at Midnight, he's Mr. Consistency. And Perry Snelson, is Mr. Speed. We got to watch those two guys over here every week.
That's for sure. 72 degrees I'm showing out on the track. So I'm not sure if that's accurate.
Yeah, that's an accurate temperature. It's pretty good. What I'm seeing, the humidity is at 81%, and that's ridiculous. Yeah. That's just wet.
Yep. That's gonna make this thing probably even more slick.
Oh, it just makes it so that you can't put down that power real easily coming up off the corners, because the truck's already fighting for grip. Then it's fighting for, the pavement's fighting back because the pavement's got moisture in it. And yeah, it's going to make for an exciting race, really. I see old D'Amico's over here.
Yeah, he must have got done with his broadcast. He was broadcasting somewhere else here a little while ago. So they must have got done with their race.
That was pretty short.
Yeah.
Maybe it went green from front to back, huh?
About an hour, maybe.
Yeah, that would suggest to me that whatever it was, they went green end to end, so that's pretty good.
Yeah. Yeah, it might not have, I'm not sure, might not have been very long. I don't know. I didn't ask how many laps it was. Danny McCune out here running. Not doing too bad. He's about sixth sixth fastest out on the track, but not too bad. Doing pretty good.
Yeah, Danny's one of those guys. He just wants to be there at the end, so just kind of position himself where he can make a run at the very end if he's got anything left. You don't try to go out and be the fastest guy every time.
Well, that's kind of the way I race. I don't really, I'm not out there for the win. I just want to finish the race, and, if I can pick up positions, I'll do it, I did that in an IndyCar race one time. I think there was like 13 or 14 of us in the field. There was more than that. It was like 20-something, I think. But anyhow, I got wrecked one time, and I sat in a pit and got IndyCar fixed up. And got back out there, and I did tap the wall a couple more times, come back in, got that fixed up. And I wound up finishing sixth that night, two laps down. I mean, that's nuts, That wasn't even fast.
So right now, it looks like we got about 13 or 14 trucks taking time out here, and we've had a couple of more join I haven't seen get on track yet. It's going to fill up. We're going to have a pretty decent little field here tonight. What did we have last week? 23? 25?
I can't remember.
There's a bunch at Vegas.
We'll see here in just a minute how many there are running out there.
I'm just looking at the timesheet right now and the people that I've seen enter that I don't see on the list, so.
Right, yeah.
You gotta subtract one name off the top there and add the other name, so you're looking at least 14. Be a pretty good feel, especially for here. That's actually not too bad. It's not too many trucks, it's not too few. We'll get some good runs.
Mm-hmm. Well, we heard that Patrick wouldn't be here tonight. He has some personal things to take care of, so. That's one that would normally be here that's not here tonight.
Yeah, Patrick is in the process of relocating his operation, and hope everything goes well for him.
Maybe he's out there watching in his spare time. Who knows? If he is, hey, Patrick, we miss you.
Well, hopefully he will come watch the replay so he can see what went on in his absence. That'd be pretty good for him, too.
Mm-hmm. at least so he can see what he missed. It's a pretty tricky track. Not one of my favorites. I always thought this would be a good go-kart track.
You got to really, really, really be rhythmic here. And this is a super, super rhythm track. And if you get out of rhythm a little bit, man, you can, one lap can mess up three. And real easy before you can get your rhythm back. You can turn into five real quick. I mean, it's one of those things where you get shuffled to the outside. It's just like being out of the draft at Daytona or Talladega. You're going to move backwards. There's no choice if you get pushed up on the high side. So, it's a real important place to really, really be rhythmic and really be smooth on. Give me one second.
Yep. All right, coming down to 2 minutes here until qualifying starts. So this, I believe, is going to be a pretty good race. Just by watching some of these guys out here practicing, I think we're going to see a decent race. Like I said earlier, we may see an extra caution or two. Hopefully not. Maybe we'll go the whole 115 laps caution-free. Love to see that. Love to see green flag run the whole way. That would be really cool. Let's see green flag pit stops get in there. Because then it's all about the driver.
Yes, yeah. Always comes down to that, really. I mean, except for some of the bigger tracks where drafting's a big key. But the driver's really important here. If you're just a little off, just a little bit, you miss a little mark here, or you miss an entry there, or you get in the gas juice or something, you can really, really cause yourself a lot of problems here.
What's the pit road speed here?
35.
That's going to
maybe
be
40. Maybe 40.
Cool. And what is the pit window? You know? Like 60 laps or something?
No, it's more like 80.
Oh, is it that much?
It's a long, long time. You can run out of tires before you can run out of fuel here pretty easy.
Yeah, tires are definitely going to be a premium.
Yeah, you want new tires every chance you get.
I think every pit stop these guys make, I believe we're going to see a four-tire change. I don't think we'll see any two-tire change unless it comes down to the end and it's for track position or something. And
late after a short run, I would agree with you. We will.
If it's just like 10 to go or something, you might see somebody duck in and just do a two-tire change. Alright, well, we're coming down to the end of it right here. We're going to get to qualifying here in just a minute. Thanks for joining us here in the broadcast. I appreciate all the Twitch viewers out there. Make sure you click that follow button underneath the viewing screen and follow us here. We do broadcast 6 nights a week, twice on Friday nights, back to back. So, but head on over to maxbtv.com and check out our schedule there. We are doing a Channel 2 also, getting into networking out, doing more broadcasting, and getting really busy. So, also catch us on Facebook at facebook.com/maxbtv. You catch all the latest news, videos, get into the conversations and stuff that are going on in there, and follow us on Facebook.
Well, the fastest guy in practice isn't going to be running the race, so I'm going to say the pole's going to probably be Snelson or McFarland tonight.
Yeah, I kind of forgot about Snelson. Snelson very fast about everywhere. So I think these guys they may have their work cut out for him, getting out front. And there he lays down the first lap already.
771, that's pretty good. That's getting around here pretty slick, really. It's all about your rhythm. And here, and especially in qualifying, you got to let the car roll. Really got to be smooth. And if it feels slow, you're probably going really fast if it's comfortable. I mean, you can overdrive it pretty easy. I was 54, and I didn't feel like I did faster than an 8. David Lowe, 69.
Hmm.
Doug Lemons with a 62, and they just keep getting quicker and quicker.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, these guys come out here with some pretty good setups. And I know all through practice, they've had 2 hours of practice out here. A lot of these guys have been dialing these setups in. So guys like David Lowe and Tim McFarlane, Rick Walker, these guys have all been working on their setups. Brandon Thomas. And it could show here tonight.
Well, neither Snelson nor McFarlane's going to end up on the pole here tonight. We'll see where Mr. Pearson puts his truck.
Now, he is not qualified yet, has he?
No.
Hmm.
He might be sitting back looking for the time he needs to beat. Trying to figure out if he's even going to make an attempt.
Danny McCoon, I don't think, has...
Pearson, 698, third best.
So three of them in the sixes.
Yeah, that's really good. Like I said, being in the sixes is good here. McCune maybe just elected not to run a qualifying lap to start at the back, play that strategy where he wants to miss anything that happens and he doesn't want to be in the middle of it, too.
That's true. Yeah, we've got about three of them that have not qualified, so.
Yeah. Yeah, about three or four yet go here.
So Doug Lemons on the pole. Wow, that's kind of a surprise to me.
That's usually pretty quick.
I didn't look for him to be on the pole though. I kind of looked for him to be maybe third, fourth, fifth, right along in there. But boy, that's pretty good. That's a heck of a smoking lap right there.
Yeah, you really did a good job putting that 62 down to take that pole.
Richmond International Raceway. All right, looks like qualifying is over, and we're going to get to Doug Lemons here once they start taking the grid.
Yeah, it's going to be It's going to be an interesting race. I think it's going to be a really good race. Like I said, these guys will slip and slide just a little bit, but as the runs go on, these guys will start to get it. They'll start to get it down, and it'll get a lot faster, a lot smoother. We're probably going to see a couple of good long green runs. I expect 30, 40 lap runs here.
All right, let's run down the qualifying order real quick here. Doug Lemon's going to be starting on the pole with a 20.624 in the number 70. Starting on the outside, David Lowe in the number 55. In third, the 83 of Stephen Pearson. In fourth, the number 10 of Timothy McFarlane. Perry Snelson has not gridded yet. He will be starting in the fifth spot. There he is, finally. Starting in the fifth spot in the number 12 on the outside of him. Brandon Thomas in the 07, Rick Walker starting in 7th in the number 68. In 8th, the 36 of Craig Johnson. In 9th, the 25 of Doug Easterday. Michael D'Amico starting on the outside of him in the 10th spot in the number 62. And Dave Smith back here in the number 33 starting 11th. And Danny McCoon starting behind him in the number 77. And it looks like there's a couple guys that did not join here. Brent Keith and Nicholas Stone. So there we have it. Getting back up here to the front. These guys getting ready to take the march off of the grid here and start rolling around the track.
Well, we're going to get ready to go here. We've only had a couple of those guys, like you said, that are not going to go ahead and grid, but these guys have one reset. You touched the wall, you were going to use it on a pit stop, but I expect to see good runs here. These guys are all good drivers. There's no halfway drivers here. They're all pretty good.
I do believe they do make two circuits around here before they get the green flag, I think.
I was just thinking the same thing.
Yeah. So they will not be going green this time, but it'll be the next time. Pit road entrance is a big key here too for these guys, so they're going to have to make sure they get them things wowed down. It's got a good entrance. It's just you got it coming off the turn. You got to make sure you get that thing slowed up before you hit pit road entrance.
Yeah, especially on the green, that pit road entry will sneak up on you. Them barrels right there are completely unforgiving.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we've seen a lot of them go right into them barrels, so. All right, Roger, getting ready to go here. You want to call this down?
You bet I will, buddy. Doug Lemon's bringing them to the green with David Lowen is outside here. Pace car's in. Green's in the air. We are underway. Midnight Motorsports Richmond Truck Series. Good jump by Lemon. Just got right out in front of Lowen. Got a good angle getting into one there.
Doug Lowe going.
Oh, Snelson's around. Snelson already hit the wall.
No caution, though.
No, he got out of the way. Yeah, that left front's jacked up on his truck already. We didn't even get a half a lap.
Man, yes it is. Yeah, he hit pretty hard on that inside wall. David Lowe trying to catch up to Doug Lemons. He's just not doing it. But he gets passed up by Stephen Pearson. Stephen Pearson rolling into second now.
I think Lowe's truck might be a little loose on the starts, and it takes a few laps for it to come to him, so he's probably biding his time, waiting for the tires to come up and get good and warm. Then he'll start inching his way back to the front. But if he's not careful, McFarland and Walker and Brandon Thomas back there are all going to be all over him trying to get that spot away.
Yeah, and now we've got a challenger, the number 68. Rick Walker does get by Timothy McFarland, and now Brandon Thomas looking to get by him. Does go backwards. Timothy McFarland going backwards pretty quick. And the 36 of Craig Johnson running in seventh.
These guys are already strung out, Rudy.
Yeah, they're already getting strung out. I think everybody's just kind of playing it safe right now. They know that it's a long race, a lot of laps ahead of them, and there's no sense in getting out here and being too aggressive yet.
Looks like Pearson's easing in on Lemons just a little bit every lap. Not real big strides, but just little bites here, little bites there. Oh, as soon as I say it, he completely misses the entry to three.
Mm-hmm.
Well, back here, McCune's making a challenge for seventh. He's going to take that away from Smith easily. Oh, and Michael D'Amico in the outside fence. No caution again. Well, maybe it wasn't D'Amico. No. It was Johnson. It looks like D'Amico's truck, but it was Johnson. And they were right there, not too far apart from each other. That's why I got crossed up.
Yep, and he is coming down pit road now. He's smoking and leaving a good smoke trail for the mosquitoes, and he's going to go a lap down.
Brandon Thomas is taking away fourth spot from Rick Walker there. He got that good run coming through three and four, and Rick just moved over and let him go down the front stretch.
Craig Johnson comes to a stop in his pit stall, changing. Looks like he's going to change all four tires. Does have a reset, and he'll get back out of here, but he's going to be restarting probably a couple of laps down now.
Easily two laps down. It's so easy to lose two laps on pit road here. It's such a short place to get around here in about 21 seconds. And, you know, at 40 miles an hour down pit road, it's an eternity.
All right, looks like the 33 here of
Dave Smith
going back to the back of the field, but does get a run back up here on Michael D'Amico, and he may be passing Michael D'Amico, and he does. Very loose coming off of, looks like that's off of turn two.
Dana McCune challenging Timothy McFarland here for about sixth place. Well, since the drop of the green, McFarland done nothing but go backwards. I thought he'd be one of the guys that would stay at the front and maybe kind of hang on and stay in the top three there. But he's worked his way all the way back to seventh place.
And you don't suppose he might have forgot to take that qualifying tape off, do you?
Yeah, but you can't do that with the trucks because we don't have incremental tape. It automatically changes it for you. But he could still have the tweaks for the setup for qualifying in, and it just isn't driving the same.
Yeah.
And that qualifying setup is not good for race.
Well, that could be it right there, then.
Will not handle very well. Our leader was already working traffic. He's got Craig Johnson three laps down already. We're not 15 laps into this race.
Yeah, this is pretty wild. Not a whole lot to talk about that's going on right now because everybody's pretty... Ooh, David Lowe getting really loose coming off of four. Saves it, but loses another position.
Yeah, he did. Well, he had that truck way sideways. That was a good piece of driving.
And again. There. Oh, and again. Oh, man. He locks it up. And he lost a bunch of...
He has angered his right rear tire something fierce.
He sure has. He's going to have to...
Has he got damage?
No,
yeah, he's got right side damage.
Wow, well, he must have hit that earlier or something.
Yeah, and that could be that he hit the wall just right, maybe where the safer barrier begins or ends. And it might have the toe knocked out on that truck a little bit. That might be what he's fighting.
Well, let's put him back to seventh now after running third. So losing a lot of positions and now running 8 seconds behind the leader. That's just how fast it can happen here at a track like this.
Doug Lemon's kind of on cruise control right now. He's just holding that 1.3, 1.4 second lead.
You're looking at Stephen Pearson still putting down some really good laps. Wishing he could get up here and race with Doug Lemon's, but yeah, you're right. Doug Lemon's really showing the way here tonight.
Yeah, last time by those two ran within 0.02 of each other. This time it was a little bigger separation. Brandon Thomas right now is fastest truck on the track. Caution's out. D'Amico spun it off of two, and I know that's his truck this time.
Looked like the 25 is the one that spun, and Michael got into him. The 25 is done.
Oh, it sure does.
Yesterday there. So
by the time I came around, the 25 was already drove away, and I thought maybe he just slowed up for that. I saw D'Amico sideways, but you're right, he'd spun out and D'Amico was trying to miss him. And
we'll take a look at this and see. He goes into the turn. I believe it went into turn one or coming off of turn two is where he spun, I think. Yeah, he was sliding it pretty good and trying to save it in one and two, and slides it sideways. The 33 catching a piece of the 25 right there, and then along comes Michael D'Amico and plows, trying to slide it to stop from hitting him, and manages to catch up to him. So that's too bad for both them drivers. But the 33 also of Dave Smith gets a piece of that. So three trucks involved in that.
Well, 20 laps before we had a caution. Not bad. Everybody on pit road. No doubt about that. Going to see four tire changes here. Some guys going to get some damage fixed.
And it looks like Doug is off first.
They're going to go in pretty much how they came out. Top five.
Come out like they went in, you mean?
I know. Did I say that backwards?
Yeah, but I knew what you meant.
Wow. I am looking at so many different things, I got myself confused. I hate when that happens.
I hear you. I can relate. There's just a lot to do here in the booth, you know, to provide a good show for you guys. And I think a lot of people don't really realize that. There's so much to do. You know, you get the cameras and try to stay focused on what's going on the track and different drivers. And there's a lot to do. All right, well, the 36 staying out, trying to get one of them laps back. But Michael D'Amico is going to go one lap down. So Craig Johnson does get one of his laps back. He'll still be at the back of the field.
Yeah, they're figuring out their lucky dog and they gave him a wave around. There was a little bit of confusion because the 62 is the first truck a lap down, but he was involved in that, so they couldn't give that to him.
All right, well, Steven Pearson going to be restarting second. Brandon Thomas now up to third. Danny McCoon fourth. Rick Walker fifth. Timothy McFarland in sixth. David Lowe back to seventh. Paris Snelson in eighth. Dave Smith ninth. Doug Easterday in tenth. Those are all the ones on the lead lap. Michael D'Amico two laps down in 11th. And Craig Johnson two laps down in 12th. I thought we had 13 out there. Nope. Never mind. 12 trucks. All right, pace car. Lights are off on the pace car. Everybody doubling up, Roger.
Yeah. Yeah, some of these guys, what are you seeing at the front or back here about mid-pack? And these guys are going to probably have to take it a little easy to try to clear traffic. So, Lemons, though, pole has led every lap. We'll just see what he does now. Pace car's in. Lemons and Pearson on front row. Green flag's in the air. We're underway once again, lap 24.
Doug gets one heck of a shot out there ahead. And now it looks like the 07 of Brandon Thomas hitting by Pearson, taking over the second spot. Also, Rick Walker getting into the mix of things. It looks like he may take up the third position. He does. He takes over the third position from Stephen Pearson.
Oh, we got a little.
Danny,
we got right in the back of McCoon. I was watching that.
Yeah.
See what happened there.
Snelson got into the back of him?
No, it was McFarland. Snelson's a victim in that one. It looks like he just drove it down in there a little further than McCoon. Well, there's about 5-6 trucks involved in that real quick.
Taking a look here and see what happens. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, Timothy McFarland, had a heck of a run coming off of turn four there.
And he got a good run. I think McCune was just kind of being easy with the guys in front of him, doing what they were doing. And I think McFarland maybe just used to drive it in just a shade deeper.
Yep.
And she drove it in too deep, got in the back of him, and wasn't much could be done. Once you make contact here, truck's coming around. That's just life. It sucks, too. They took out some quick trucks. It's going to narrow the field. Most of them have already used their reset. I need to look at Snelson and see what he's got for damage.
It looks like...
Oh, yeah, extensive.
A few of them did pit, but not all of them. You know, it kind of... just back.
I think anybody that wasn't involved in it, nobody that was not involved in the wreck did not pit. All the guys that were involved had to come down. Snelson's truck is mashed up real good on the front. Both sides are just mashed up on the front end there. So that's going to make an interesting ride for him the rest of the race.
Well, you don't want to have a ride here that's tough because it makes for a long day.
Usually on a short track, it don't matter a whole lot. But here, you need all the downforce you can get. This place is slick enough, got just little enough grip. You want every bit you can manufacture mechanically. And his truck won't be making any mechanical grip right now.
Craig Johnson and Timothy McFarland still on pit road. What's going on with them, Roger?
Lots and lots of damage.
Okay, both of them, huh?
Yeah, I think Johnson's got the toe knocked out on the left side of that truck. He's sitting in the pit stall straight. Tires look straight, but that steering wheel looks like she's turned about 30 degrees to the right. So,
well, Michael D'Amico should be the wave by. Looks like he is getting away by now. So that'll put him one lap now, I believe.
Should put him back on the lead lap.
Back on the lead lap. I apologize.
10th position on the lead lap. And getting back to pit road, McFarland's truck, the front end is worse than actually Perry Snelson's, and I thought his was bad. You can see both tires sticking out of the front fenders, and the nose is just really mangled up there, so he's got a lot of work to do. He probably got the toe knocked out of that one, too. Snelson's back on pit road, getting his damage fixed. Probably about the best he can do for a little while until we get into the caution.
All right, well, the lights are off on the pace car, and everybody's doubling up here, Roger, and we're going green next time by. Led every lap so far, 30 laps in the books. We still got about 85 to go.
Yeah, we're going to take the green with 84.
Yes, sir.
Everybody's caught up to the field now, except for McFarland, who's still on pit road.
Green flag waves. Here we go.
Man, Lemons did not get that good a start, and Brandon Thomas is right there. He's got a shot at this. He decided to take it real easy and not push the issue through one and two.
He would like.
He doesn't want to lose second.
And you know what? Brandon Thomas led that lap. So he did get
good for Brandon.
He got credit for leading the lap. Just long enough to lead it, and that was about it.
Well, Dan McCune, after all that mess he got into, still had his reset. His truck looks fine out there now.
Well, that's good. You know, it's early, though. I mean, I hope he can keep that thing straight now and keep it back up in the hunt. Back here, you know, we say caution, precaution, but we don't want to see that happen again. See these guys run it green the rest of the way, it would be really awesome. But I don't look for that.
Well, we're strung out here single file real fast. That's going to help. You just want to get some laps on these tires. Maybe find out that guy that's real fast for the first 20 laps in the run, maybe he wears his stuff out and you know, a guy in third, fourth, fifth place that's got a good long run. So we almost had a big wreck off two right there. Sorry about that. 33 just barely got into one. 83 almost ran him clean over.
And 33 way up the hill now, and Stephen Pearson gets by him. And it looks like we may have another one, the 55 of David Lowe getting by him.
He got on the outside. He's going to get by. If he ain't careful, Easterly's going to get by him too. And these front guys are just really kind of mirroring each other, not really doing anything drastic here. The front three, kind of keeping the same distances. Craig Johnson has officially taken his car to the house. McClellan's still on pit road getting work done.
Yeah, if we could get out there and increase time a couple more laps and at least when we finish the dead last, I'm sure if we get that thing fixed up, he will.
Yeah, he'll trooper on. He'll get a few laps in. Front two are starting. Oh. Thomas has started to close the gap on Lemons a little.
He sure has, yeah. He's right there within 3/10 of him, wanting to get up there and lead a lap. Another lap.
He's just got to be patient, not overdrive here. He overdrove at Exxon on 2 last lap. Really hung that right rear out.
I see that. Yeah. And that's the kind
of thing. Do that too many times, and pretty quick you can't stop from doing it because that right rear gets hot and he just has no grip left in it.
Well, that cost him about 1/10. Here's a lot. You know, that's a couple car lengths.
It doesn't take long to lose 1/10. It takes a long time to get it back.
Sure does. Especially if the guy that you're chasing is as fast as you are. You know, it's just, you can't, it's hard to reel them in.
Yeah, like I said, these guys are mirroring each other on lap times, and so, you know, if you're just a couple of hundredths quicker, it takes, you know, 5, 6, 7 laps to get there again, whereas, you know, it doesn't take but just the blink of an eye and you've lost 1/10.
Now Brandon right down there again within 3/10 of Doug, putting the pressure on Doug. Doug can't afford to make a mistake right now.
No, and neither can Brandon, and the two of them, God, I realize, race within yourself. Don't try to overdrive the track. Don't try to overpower your exits. Just keep doing what you've been doing, and you'll either hold your spot or the guy that's coming is going to be a little quicker, and he's going to work it over, find an opening, and he's going to take it away. And both of them got to realize that and just stay nice and smooth and steady. And the battle's actually shaping up here for third.
Yeah, looking back on that right now, Rick Walker actually starting to gain a little bit. Oh, and Brandon gets loose again coming off of two. Two's going to be his killer tonight.
Yeah, he's gets so close, and he gets a little anxious, I think, about trying to get that run right there. And what he doesn't realize is he's getting a better run through three and four every time than one and two, and that's where he's going to end up making up all his time, making his pass.
And let that thing go.
Pearson challenging Rick Walker. Got a great run through one and two.
Sure is good battle going on here between them two. Boy, and he's got a nose up under him, and it looks like Steven is going to take over that position. Hasn't quite there. He finally cleared him.
McCune was looking to try to get down in there, but Walker shut that door. But McCune got a good run off of two. He's going to be able to do this in three and four. Walker working back.
Looking back on that battle, McCune coming up on the inside here of Rick Walker. Rick happened to go up the hill a little bit.
David Lowe is going to be able to get the next spot on him. Once you get on the outside here, it's really, really hard to get back down.
Sure is, yep. And David Lowe going to pass him. So, wow, Rick Walker lost a bunch of positions. That just
he went from third to sixth in about four laps.
Jeez, oh man.
Well, now it'd take 35 or 40 laps to get those spots back.
Yeah, he could be just kind of playing it easy right now. But now David Lowe on the outside of Danny McCune taking a peek, but not going to be able to cut that pass on the outside. Now taking a peek on the inside.
If he would have been able to get up there and make that pass on the outside, I'd have stood out of my chair and cheered out loud for him. And it looks like he is going to be able to do it on the inside here, though. Once you get up top, man, just you got to take your poison, try to find the hole, jump down, and then get settled back in and go back after. Just try to only give up one, maybe two spots. On the outside sucks here bad. And now Doug Lemon's really just getting away from Brandon Thomas. I think Thomas kind of hurt his tires a little, trying to get there too hard. Now he's going to have to settle in and let everything work itself out, get through pit stops, maybe throw an adjustment at it, and try to run that time, whatever he loses here, down on the next run.
Well, Doug is just so smooth, you know. He's just, I'm on him right now, and he is just so smooth coming off the turns.
What's wild is they actually probably could make it the rest of the way without
fuel
or tires.
Oh, man. It'll be a long race out here on them tires.
Oh, and the end of it is just you praying for it to end or for a caution to come out. After about 50, 60 laps here, you're just praying for that. It gets monotonous, but if you have to fight it all with your setup and the tires, it just gets so overwhelming. And you just beg for end. Please let it end.
McFarland back out on the track now.
26. Yeah, he's made a lap a couple of times I saw, Rudy. Sorry about that, but he's made a lap and went back in, and I saw him go and make another lap and go back in. So he's going to move up. It's just that truck's not fixed.
Yeah. I think he's struggling with it right now. It's got a lot of damage on that thing still. And he may not have sat in there and got it all fixed. I don't know. Because it looks like the right front corner's still got an awful lot of damage on it.
Now, Michael D'Amico gets lapped out here as the leaders have come up and start working a little bit of lap traffic.
Michael probably struggling with a tight condition, it looks like, because I noticed he was a little loose coming off the corners, but it's tight pushing up the hill, and it's so tight he's trying to hold it down to keep into the throttle, and it just makes that rear end come right around on him.
Yeah, that'd probably be a product of a little bit of damage that he's got, making him tight in the center. He may be overdriving his entries just a little bit, so he's not letting the truck rotate. And then he's just trying to force it to do something on exit that it's just not prepared to do.
Well, we're about the
Pearson's halfway. Going to give up third spot to David Lowe here.
We're at the halfway mark. These guys, when they cross the line, will be just a hair past halfway.
Lemons, Thomas, Lowe, Pearson, McCune running in the top five here. Same guys we saw earlier in the race running the top five. And I think everybody knows what they got. I think they know what they need to do when we get to these pit stops, if we get to have them, which I'm kind of doubting now. If this thing were to stay green, I don't think anybody would pit. I think everybody would try to make it.
Yeah, I think you're right. Yeah, it may be close, but you should be able to do it.
Yeah, we had about, 84 laps off, but really, you might actually be able to make a little few closer to the end of the run when you really got to stay off the throttle for a long time. Some of these guys might actually make it. It's going to depend on the gear they're running.
Dave Smith off the track in the number 33. I don't see him out there racing at all, so looks like we have another one that has retired.
Yeah, he had a little bit of damage, and he just wasn't up to speed anymore. I think maybe he decided that enough was enough. This place is toughing up, and with a damaged truck, it's even worse.
Yeah, that's for sure. All right, so David Lowe still running in third now. Back to Stephen Pearson in fourth. Still hasn't been able to catch up to David Lowe, but still hanging on there. Danny McCune riding in fifth. Back here in sixth, Rick Walker going underneath the lap down truck of Michael D'Amico.
Right about now is the time that all these guys, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, are going, man, there's debris on the track. There's something laying on turn two or turn four. So they're just begging for a caution right now.
Snelson running in the seventh position, doing pretty good out here after having a couple of them couple tanglements I don't think he really wanted. But I think he's struggling with a little bit of a loose truck, too.
And he's still got a little bit of nose damage. They did a pretty good job of pulling those fenders out. I just think he's just off. Maybe the toe's still a little bit out of that truck, and he's just, you know, he's just fighting a bad mechanical deal right now.
Yep.
And McFarland out there riding around, tons of damage on the right side of that truck still, but they got the left side looking pretty good again.
Brandon Thomas now 1.8 seconds behind our leader, Doug Lemons. Doug led all but one lap of this race. We've had two leaders, and that would be Doug Lemons and Brandon Thomas. Brandon got that one just on that restart. Roger, that he was like crossed the line when they got the green flag, just about a fender ahead of Doug Lemons and got that lap.
Yeah, that last restart, he really was on top of it when Lemons went. He was right with him.
He sure
ready
was.
To go.
He sure was.
And these two are running, I mean, almost identical lap times.
Yeah, he's
But David running. Lowe is the truck that's the fastest on the track right now, Rudy.
Yeah, he's definitely on a mission here to try to get up here. I think he wants to get up there and lead a lap, too. If the thing would stay green all the way, I don't know what he's got for the long run. He may have a good setup for the long run. I don't know.
Lemons might have burned his stuff up because he's coming back at a pretty good clip to these two behind him. But Lowe's still getting a little bit on Thomas. About every other lap, he gets a little bit on him.
We'll take a look here and watch as... David Lowe starts to reel in Brandon Thomas, and we'll just kind of keep an eye on the distance between them. Right now it's about 9/10 of a second.
And Lemons now reaching down in his bag. He's starting to drive away just ever so slightly again.
Yeah, Brandon's losing about maybe a tenth. Every couple laps. So
was it 80? It was 86 to 86 last lap for these two.
Yeah.
Or 89-86. Lemons ran 21-89 and Thomas ran 21-86. So it's a tiny bit here or a tiny bit the other way every lap.
Yep. And now he's back about 1 3/4 second back behind the leader. So Brandon Thomas stole. Trying to hang on there, 1.8 seconds now. So he's starting to lose about a tenth a lap now.
And before that, he had gained a tenth a lap for three or four laps. Now the last three or four laps, he's actually lost some distance to him. The leader's coming up on the lap truck of Doug Easterly here in eighth position. Now Lowe started to fade all the way back. And the real battle really is going to be for fourth any time now because McCune, oh, and Pearson spinning it down the front stretch.
Oh, my.
It's going to bring out caution.
Yes, sir. That's going to bring caution out.
Lap 73, we get caution.
Come back and take a look at this.
Yeah, most of these guys are thanking that guy right about now.
And
he's kicking himself.
Like coming down the backstretch, going into turn three, maybe. I would say probably coming off of turn... Yeah, coming off of turn four, he gets really loose right in front of Danny McCune. And just brings it on around. Doesn't hit anything or anybody. So good job by Stephen Pearson. Excuse me.
All our leaders are on pit road.
And we'll take a peek here and watch them as they come around and see who's going to come out on top here. I'm sure the way Doug's been hitting his pit stall and everything. I'm sure he'll come out on top on this one. Right side's going on. Him and David Lowe right
Thomas here. Is already dropping off the jack right now.
And there he goes. Doug off first. Brandon Thomas second. David Lowe third. Danny McCoon fourth. And Rick Walker fifth. Wow.
And I think Lemons might have gotten busted.
Uh-oh.
Lemons got busted going in. Speeding. Too fast, entering pit road.
Oh, man. Well, I'm showing Brandon Thomas out in front here.
Yeah, he will be. Because the 70 truck of Doug Lemons, too fast entering pit road. Probably the second section right there. The mistake that you can't make right there. There's the mistake you can't make.
Yep.
And he made it.
As much as these guys want to see pit road, you know, to get fresh tires and stuff, they don't want to. Just reasons like that is why they don't want to come down pit road.
Yep.
It's all about the driver and, you know, these guys trying to get in and off pit road so fast, and that's how they make mistakes.
Getting into pit road to your box, getting out of your box and off of pit road is all driver. Once you're in the box, then it's up to the crew. However, they, whatever mistakes they make. But you make that mistake coming in or going out, and that's all on the driver right there. Every bit of it.
Yeah, he's going to, oh man. So what's that dude?
Michael D'Amico is going to get our wave around again.
That gives him an EOL, right?
He's going to start at least seventh in the order. And he's going to be about 8th or 9th, actually, on the track because he has to go to the very end of the longest line.
Oh, my.
That's he's got his work cut out on him. He's going to get some back up to the front, but by the time he gets through all the traffic, you know, when everybody was kind of getting equal on times there, him and Thomas and Lowe were all getting equal on times there, he may not be, you know, back to the lead. He may be 3rd. He may be 4th by the time that all works out. It depends on how hard it is from the pass gas.
Well, Timothy Mack now back up. He's in the top 10. So good job getting that truck out there and getting it, picking up a couple positions and getting it into the top 10. Going to be 25 laps down, but still out there running. Wow.
Yeah, we missed our opportunity there to get a real big interview, but we were so caught up in everything that was going on that I forgot.
Yeah, me too. We will do the next one.
Yeah, we get another caution, we definitely need to do an in-race interview.
This is,
restart number 3?
Yes,
yeah.
Sir.
Yeah.
And we've had 3
leads. Race cars in. Brandon Thomas and David Lowe are going to bring us to the green this time. Green's in the air. Ooh, they were all sleeping right there. They got almost to the line before anybody went. But Thomas gets through, and Danny McCoon goes with him. Rick Walker looks like he's going to drop inside real quick and try to get that spot off below. Boy, that's just outside's terrible to be on.
Yeah. And David Lowe going back to the third position now. Danny McCoon in second. Rick Walker really, really pushing the envelope right there. Wanted to get by these guys. But boy, I'll tell you, he just didn't have enough power to get by them.
Pearson made a power move there on Snelson to get fifth away from him, try to get after these boys up front. We got a wreck in the back of the 25 truck. Doug Easterly goes around down in one and brings out another caution. That is a big help to the 70 truck of Doug Lemons. Everybody missed him. Good job, drivers.
He brings it way down low, and you know that's not where you want to enter the turn. And when he tries to come off, it looks like he might have been chasing it a little bit.
Yeah, he may have had to hop on the brakes real hard right there in the center to try to get it to turn in just the wrong place. Yeah. I don't know that we'll see these guys come in. I'm going to be surprised if we do.
Michael D'Amico. Oh man, they just missed him.
Ooh, I thought everybody was going to come in. Well, Rudy, I think let's get us a holler down here at David Lowe and see what the racing's like.
All right, let me open a channel for you, buddy. You got it?
David Lowe, Roger Wagner up the booth. You got a copy?
Got you loud and clear.
Hey, man, we've seen you going forward, seen you going backwards. How is the racing really out there tonight with these conditions, all this humidity and everything?
Well, the track's slick to me, but I made some changes on the truck. Probably shouldn't have, but I think I've got it right now. It's real good on a long run. I was running there behind, I don't know if it was Danny or Brandon, but I called him and I just backed off of him, just let him run. Didn't want him to try to overdrive or nothing and take a chance on wrecking us, but the truck's pretty good.
Yeah, we usually see you kind of do that sneaky at the end thing anyway. We kind of come to expect that from you. As far as, Doug looked like maybe got himself in a little pickle there and sped on pit road or something, but did you think you had something for him? Had he stayed out in the front and that long green run had continued to go on to the end? I think everybody could make it, couldn't they?
Yeah, I think we could have made it. I might have could have got to him, but I don't know if I could have got around him. And I sure wasn't going to wreck him again like I did last week. So don't count him out because he'll be back up here. Just watch.
Oh, yeah, we got our eye on him. We got our eye on a couple of guys out here. We just wanted to check with you and see how the track was doing and how your truck was set up. We kind of figured we're going to see you make that late race run that we always see. So good luck with that, and hopefully we'll get to talk to you at the end of the race here in Victory Lane, buddy.
Thank you.
All right. So maybe he's got something for him if it goes the rest of the way green.
Well, he explained to me how he got all the way up to Thomas's bumper there, and then all of a sudden he's, you know, a second behind him. He let him go just so he wasn't putting a lot of pressure on him.
Mm-hmm.
It's smart racing. I mean, it really is. It's really smart racing. Once you make that second run at the guy will realize that, hey, this guy's a little faster than me. Maybe I'll just let him go, and then I don't have to get under pressure here. So it's smart racing. It's thoughtful heads-up racing.
It looks like we're going to get the green with about 30 to go here to finish this up.
Yeah, we should get the one to go right here with about 30.
No, that's 30.
That'll be a good run.
That's 30.
That'll be a good run. Is it? Okay, I'm miscalculating. Yep. But yeah, I mean, it's going to be good. If they can do these last 30 in green, we're going to get to see. We're definitely going to have to see where that 70 truck is, because he only picked up about, one spot in there? Two spots?
Yeah.
That, and that's because one truck's gone.
Yep, so he's mired back into seventh place back there, Doug Lemons is. So, and, he's got a couple good trucks he's going to have to get by, but I don't know. I think he might be going to just try to pick them off one at a time here.
Let them get closer to the front file. You get, the harder they are to pass, Rudy. You know that.
Let them all get single file. Okay, everybody.
Here we go. Base car's in. Green's out. Thomas goes. Boy, he had Lowe right on his bump when he went. That's going to give Lowe the inside on McCune in one here.
McCune stuck up on that high side and going to get free
training. Oh, and Pearson got into Walker, and I think that was a product of McCune wiggling out high. I don't think that was anything other than Walker reacting to McCune.
So Snelson into that. Well, let's go back and take a look at this.
Well, we got two or three that got in that afterwards, I guess.
Yeah, I'm kind of watching the replay here, and we'll see who gets into this and who doesn't.
Yeah, it looks like Pearson just slid up off the bottom a little right there.
Oh, yeah. He sure did.
I thought maybe Walker reacted to McCune being on the outside and making that little wiggle and cut down a little. And it does look like he started to make the cut down, but he never comes across that line. Pearson just kind of, I don't know, washes the nose out a little or something, and he never really turned in the center of the corner, and they got together. It's a racing deal. There was no, nothing bad, no evil intent behind it. It just one of the things, you're in tight quarters, and somebody does something, you got to react to it. And I think Pearson put his foot down instead of just letting the truck roll, maybe. Like I said, I don't think it was intentional at all. Just basically, it's unfortunate for Rick Walker, Barry Smelson. I think Michael D'Amico got a little piece of that.
I think he missed it. I'm looking.
Well, I think he spun as they went past. I think he was trying to miss it and he spun. But Snelson's truck is just beat up all around, and Rick Walker's truck is beat up pretty bad on the back. Now, Nose still looks really good, but he's beat up pretty good on the back end. We'll see what that does. Loose is not good here.
Well, Rick looked like to me Rick Walker may have come right down into Pearson. Pearson didn't go up the hill.
Okay, well, yeah. My view, I kind of saw a little bit of both. Like I said, I don't think Walker came down that far, on my opinion. I think that when Pearson saw that Danny wiggled a little up top, he tried to jump the throttle because if he was going to turn and come down the track, he wanted to be past it, and it made the nose wash out on his truck, and he came up a little, and the two ended up running together.
All right, well, looks like Michael D'Amico may have taken his truck behind pit wall.
Ooh.
Coming down to 20 to go here shortly. Ain't got too many more to go. About 25 to go.
Well, the front five are still out there.
Danny McCoon going to be restarting third. David Lowe going to be restarting on the outside of Brandon Thomas here. So let's see if David Lowe's got anything for Brandon on this restart, because Brandon's been pretty quick on these restarts.
Yeah, last time he started right behind him, and boy, was he up on his bumper on that restart. This time he's going to be on the outside. Let's see what that does for him.
Snelson on pit road, Rick Walker on pit road, Easterday on pit road. So a lot of pit road takers here, maybe getting some tires changed.
Getting some fenders pulled out mostly, I think.
And, you know, even if they didn't, I think I would take some four fresh tires here, trying to hang on to these leaders and maybe have a chance for a win here. But the lights are off
Ben
on the pace
Lemons.
Car.
Greg Lemons said going in and taking tires, and I do see D'Amico's truck back on track now.
Oh, okay, yep.
We're going to have here, Rudy, about 25?
25 right now.
24?
24 to go when they cross the line.
Yeah. Well, Lemon's got closer. He just keeps getting closer with every caution to the front.
Pace car's off.
Green's out. Oh, he spun the tires, and that's going to give David Lowe the chance.
Danny McCoon almost rear-ended him. Boy, that could have been costly. Could have been a big pileup. David Lowe
can't spin the tires. Oh, and Lowe gets it into the fence trying to get it off, too. That's going to cost him a couple of spots. And Doug Lemons is going to try to shove this thing right in this door while it's open on Lowe, too.
So Danny McCoon now moving into the second place. And Lowe diving. Man, he tried to dive bomb down and like. Danny McCoon closed that door right up on him.
Well, he really went after McCoon right there.
But here we are, Doug Lemons in fourth, wanting to get up here and win this thing.
Low wiggled here coming off a four, and that's going to give the door open to Lemons going down in a one. Wow, he piled it in there. Man, he had to get on the brakes.
What a power move. And Brandon knows that he's coming. And I don't know. You think he's got enough to stay out ahead of him? Coming to 20 to go here in just another lap.
Well, I know he could get there to the back end of McCune, but he's going to really work to get around the 77 and the 07, and we'll see if he can do that in the next 20 laps. It's not going to be a simple task. It can be done. Anybody could do it. I think he probably could. He's got the truck for it. It's just that you got to really run hard. And every time you run it a little harder, you eat them tires a little more. By the time you get to doing what you got to do, sometimes you just ain't got the equipment to do it with no more.
Yeah, and here's the thing that is hurting Doug right now is he's not in clean air. You know, we've seen this so many times. A guy that's out front there in that clean air seems to have a good advantage. You know, you're not in the wake of somebody else's air disturbance, you know. And
Pearson's working on Lowe.
Doug hasn't felt that, you know, and now he's feeling it.
And Steven Pearson inside David Lowe there. He's going to take that fourth spot away down here in 3 and 4.
He sure does. So David Lowe going backwards.
If Thomas can just be smart, be smooth, you know, not try to overpower anything, I think he's got a chance to hang on here. We're getting down to 15 to go here. 15 laps will go by really fast, and Lemons is not making up ground on these two at all.
No, he's not. He was at first there, and I think now that he's kind of got the tread war a little bit on them tires and got them a little bit warm, I don't think he's quite as fast as he was. He may be a little bit better on the long run than these guys, but they're not going to have much of a long run here.
No, it was only going to be, you know, 30 laps, and that's not very long at Richmond. Yeah. That goes by quick. Now we're down to 16 to go right now.
Yeah. And he does not seem to be gaining on them at all. He's still about 1.2 seconds behind them.
Yeah, and they've got a comfortable margin between Thomas and McCune here. And, you know, it's looking like Brandon Thomas may just be able to cruise here and stay smart and smooth and bring this victory home. About the only race on the track right now is for third and fourth between, or fourth and fifth, I'm sorry, between Pearson and Lowe. They're the only two that are really close to each other and have any chance of racing each other, really.
Pearson, he keeps blinking out, and that's costly for you when you're blinking like that, because believe it or not, it'll cost you a tenth real quick. And he can't afford to lose a tenth, because David Lowe's fast, and David Lowe slipped up that time, and boy, I'll tell you what, he lost a lot of ground to Pearson. He is really struggling with he's loose going in. I don't know if he's overdriving it going in or what, but boy, I'll tell you, he's loose going in, Roger.
Maybe his adjustment isn't good for his entries, might be good for his exits. And maybe that's where he was struggling before. But every time you make an adjustment to fix one thing, you give up a little bit on the other end. So if you fix the entry, you give up a little on your exits. If you fix your exits, you're going to give a little on your entry. He might have done just a little too much trying to get that exit good.
And Doug Lemons is starting to lose ground to these leaders. He's dropped a couple tenths now in the last couple laps. So
11 to go.
Yeah, I don't think he's going to have anything out here for Brandon Thomas. Brandon's going
to. And he's going to have to watch his back window, because Pearson's coming. I think these Raw Power Motorsports guys got this figured out for the end of this race. If they finish 1-2-3, that'll be pretty exciting for them.
Oh, and David Lowe, loose coming off of two again, saves it though. That was insane right there. Man.
Yeah, that was pretty interesting. And Pearson is chipping away at Lemons. He's got it down to under half a second.
Danny McCune up here in second, just hanging on to Brandon, but I don't think he's got enough time to close up on him now.
Caution. The 25 truck spun her out off of two. Well, that's going to change things just a little. These guys are going to have to make a tough decision now.
And hits the inside wall, so let's go back and take a look at that again. Doug Easterday.
Yeah, it looked like he twitched getting down in the corner and just never got her back, and it just finally looped out on him coming off. He's had so much rear end damage this whole race that, you know, I'm sure it's made that truck loose as it is, and he just finally, you know, lost the battle.
It kind of took a little bit of a...
He's going to pits. Man. He took it to the garage.
Oh,
I watched him drive it right between the walls and go right in the garage.
Oh, man.
All right. Well, hey, all your leaders are in. Let's stay focused on the 70 and the 07. Those are the two. I mean, McCune's up there, and he's been running second this last run. But the 70 was the truck to beat early. The 07 has been the only thing close to matching him. If they get out 1-2, that's where we're going to decide it right here.
Yeah, now, I wouldn't take any fuel.
Ooh. Oh, the 77 takes two. Brandon Thomas, Doug Lemons takes two, gets out second.
Wow, that was that was pretty wild right there. Oh man, this changed everything.
Four or five laps. Yeah, it's way different now because Lemons only took rights, and it's a good move. It was a great move. The other guys did too. He just got it done way faster than Thomas, and I don't know how Thomas came out third out of that deal.
Well, Danny McCune had a 7.6 second pit stop. Doug Lemons had a 7.1 second pit stop. And Brandon Thomas had a 9 second pit stop.
Wow, that's, you know, 2 seconds. And there's your dairy. Yeah. That lost him a spot. I lost him 2 spots on pit road.
Yep. Yep. Yeah, almost 2 seconds difference. So that could have cost Brandon the race right there.
It probably did. You're only going to have about 3 laps.
Yeah.
McCune's got to get a good restart, and then he's just got to hold Lemons off for a couple of laps.
Well, so Easter Day will probably finish in the ninth position because I don't think there ain't enough laps left to for Timothy to gain that position away from him. So Doug will finish ninth.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what it looks like. Well, the good...
It'll be interesting.
The good news is for Thomas is he's going to get to start on the inside behind the guy that's going to set the pace at the start here. So if he can stick with McCune and get it down into 1 and 2, he might be able to steal that second place away early, and then he can set his sights on going after McCune. But if he doesn't get it right on the first lap, and there's a chance that Thomas just cost himself this race on pit road.
Yep. Off on the pace car, and Roger, call this down because this is going to be the final sprint to the win right here.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to this. You're only going to have about 3 laps here. McCune, Lemons, Thomas, Stephen Pearson, David Lowe will be your top five right here. Snelson's still on lead. He's 2 laps down. He's the first car lap down. Pace car's in. Green flag is out. Well, they restart. That's a good restart. Everybody's kind of even.
Just exactly like you said, Brandon Thomas trying to stick right with Danny McCune. Danny slides it up in front of Lemons. Oh, man.
Lemons got in the back of McCune.
Oh, man. That was kind of a dirty move.
And Pearson got in there. This is going to end the race, folks. Caution is out. Danny McCune's going to be your winner.
There's going to be some upset drivers in this one. Let's go back and take a look at this because the one that kind of really took the beating on that was Doug Lemons.
Yeah, he had car truck inside and he cut down quite a bit. But Pearson really got in a little hot and was drifting up. But it's another one of them racing deals where out here you're going to have bumping and rubbing and things are going to happen. But that was just two guys trying to get the same piece of real estate.
Right here on Doug Lemons, and boy, and I'll tell you what, he took a beating on this. Pearson pushing him up the hill, just slamming him and taking him out. Oh, man. Yeah, I don't think Doug's going to be too happy with that. Pearson drove that in there really hard.
Well, I mean, some days you get the bear and some days the bear gets you, But in most cases, I mean, you know, it's short track racing, and you're going to have some bumping and rubbing. Guys are going to touch. It's how you react to it that really makes a difference.
But that's going to put Lemons, looks like maybe, I'm not sure, back to maybe
fourth.
Seventh or something.
Fourth. Pearson pulled his truck on, so that's going to finish in fourth. Pearson will finish probably fifth.
All right, well, I'll open a channel for you whenever you let me know, and we'll get in
there. Yeah, we'll catch this winner. let him get around here and kind of get done with the congratulations and this and that, and we'll jump down there. Good race. I mean, we had, you know, some bumps and bruises early. We had some late, but cautions breed cautions.
Exactly. Maybe I ought to have all the three podium guys sit right on the start-finish line. That would be good.
Yeah.
And Danny McCoon's going to park it? No, he ain't going to park it.
Let's see. We'll see if we can get an interview when he gets them burning out.
Just let me know when to open the mic.
All right, let's have her here.
Next week.
Go for it.
Danny McCune, Roger Wagner up in the booth. You got a copy?
10-4.
Good win tonight, man. I mean, you started a little deeper in the field, worked your way up there a little bit. We saw you kind of run at the front. Kind of take us through your race tonight, man. That was pretty impressive way you held off the field right there on the end right there.
Yeah, I started in on the tail end. Figured I'd try and save my reset, and it worked out.
Yeah. Was the track as slick as it looked from up here?
Oh yeah, it was really slick.
Well, it looks like you and your teammates kind of got her dialed in at the end. You guys were running up there at the front. Did you have any thoughts that maybe even your teammate Brandon Thompson could get by you, let alone old Doug Lemons there?
Well, I think I kind of slid up into Doug a little bit on that last restart. I drove it down into one, and it definitely didn't stick with two tires. But Brandon, I was going to let him go by whenever he got under me, whenever I slid up the track. But he got loose or something, so I just pulled it back down, and then the caution came out.
Well, it was a good win. It's good to see you finish up at the front there. Be your team proud. Any fans or any sponsors or anything you need to say hey to here?
Yeah, I'd like to thank Roger Wagner for the setup and good run on Team RPM.
That would be you.
All right, man. I think Rudy's got your teammate here for second place.
Brandon Thomas, this is Rudy Cummings in the booth. You got a copy?
Yeah, I got you, Rudy.
Brandon, good job bringing it home second today. You had it out front there, kind of slipped up on your last pit stop. You had a long pit stop, like 9-second pit stop, and the other guys had a 7.1, a 7.6, so you pretty much kind of lost that on pit road. Tell us about your pit stop on that last one.
Yeah, my right front tire carrier got hit by a truck coming by. And that slowed us down a little bit.
All right. Well, you know, the race went pretty good out there. Not a lot of cautions, a couple of good long green flag runs. But you come home second today, and great job. Congratulations to you on that, buddy. I'd like to see you bring it home in victory lane. Of course, I'd like to see all of you bring it home in victory lane, but unfortunately, there can only be one winner. Danny definitely outdrove everybody. Do you think two tires was the best call on that last pit stop?
I don't know. Doug definitely had a faster truck early on. Three or four yellows from the end there. I made a few changes, tightened it up. I think I got it a little bit better. I definitely hated to see that second to last caution. I think I had it wrapped up with about 10 to go there. So I definitely hated to see that. There on the last, what was the last lap, I tried to get a run under Danny and just got loose. I couldn't make it stick. It was either lift or go up and risk taking my teammate out. So I'll bring it home second week in a row.
All right. Well, great job out there today, Brandon. Congratulations again. And you want to give a shout-out to any fans or friends, family, or anybody that could be watching?
Yeah, I just want to say thank you to RPM Motorsports for building a great setup. I think all three of us had very fast trucks tonight. I'm not sure exactly what happened to Steven there at the end, but it was a good night all around.
All right, Brandon. Thanks a lot, buddy. Okay, Roger.
David Logan, you got a copy?
Yeah, man, I'm here.
Well, buddy, we talked earlier. You told me you made some adjustments, and I kind of kept an eye on you during that run after you told me you made those. And I got to ask you, did you go the right way or did you go too far the right way?
I went the wrong way. And that last pit stop that we made, that last yellow, I went back to what I had before. I made the changes and stuff. I'd have had something for them there if that caution hadn't come out. I really tightened it up. So good win for them, and I hated to see it come out, but it happens. But all in all, it was a good night of racing. I just went the wrong way. I had my little girl in here chatting with me and stuff and got sidetracked and went the wrong way on the spring perch, and I had it so loose. I'm sure if you was watching me, it was like driving on ice.
Yeah, we saw, especially on your exit, the thing was dancing all over the place. I mean, you still come home third, you know. I know you wanted to win. I know you think you had something for them. So, I mean, overall, for all the changes and everything that went on, you got to be at least a little satisfied with a third place finish. You got any fans or any fans out there watching you might want to say hi to?
Yeah, I'd like to say thanks to Doug Lemons. Me and him worked on a setup and figured some stuff out. And I hate that he got wrecked there at the end, but thank him and Rick. He set up a practice room for us earlier, and we went in there and come up with something pretty good. So I'd like to thank Midnight Motorsports for putting this on for us and everything, and especially Rick. He's the one that does all this for all of us. And Rick and Doug and friends of mine, and we'll get a win eventually.
Well, congratulations on the third place finish tonight. And all in all, I think everybody had a pretty good night out there. We saw the bumps and bruises, but overall, I think it was a good run. And we'll look forward to seeing y'all next week. I believe we're going to California.
Yes.
All right, Rudy.
Okay, well, let's run down the results here real quick. We're going to wrap this up here. Danny McCoon coming home, our winner here tonight. Brandon Thomas finishing 0.4 seconds behind him. David Lowe slipping by a couple of the guys here. It looked like Doug Lemons slipped back a little bit. And David Lowe coming home third spot. Doug Lemons finishing fourth. Steven Pearson finishing fifth. Perry Snelson in sixth. Michael D'Amico seventh. Rick Walker eighth. Doug Easterday finishing in the ninth position. Timothy McFarland bringing home a top 10 today. Dave Smith, 11th, and Craig Johnson in the 12th position. So, Roger, sum up the race here. What did you think of the race here tonight?
Well, I think we kind of got what we predicted beginning. We got a couple of really good long runs after we got through the bumps and the bruises of the guys figuring out what they had and how far they could push. The early cautions kind of set up for an interesting middle of the race there. Lemons was definitely the truck to beat from about lap 30 to about lap 75 or 80. And then it looked like Brandon Thomas was the truck to beat after that until we got right down to the end. As we say every week, pit stops will make or break your race. I don't care if they're under green or under caution. And we saw a yellow flag pit stop cost Brandon Thomas a shot at this win tonight, in my opinion. And his teammate took it away, got out first, and he ended up winning it on a real late caution, which was just a product of hard racing between two guys. I hope nobody has hurt feelings over that. I think we saw a pretty good race. I mean, you know, this place is tricky. When you got the humidity up high and it's making it even slicker, it's hard to race here. And that made an extra element that made it even that much more difficult. And all these guys handled it great, and we saw some good fun racing.
Absolutely. Ricky, you joined us in the booth here. Anything that you wanted to say?
Yeah, I just wanted to thank Dave and Doug today. They both pitched in, helped pay for all of this, and and just thank everybody for showing up. You guys doing a great job, and I appreciate it. Also, I wanted to let Steve Pearson understand that that wasn't his fault. He was thinking that it was his fault. I actually came down on him and wrecked myself.
Oh, okay.
I think we looked at that. I think we kind of figured out that it was kind of a racing deal. I mean, I thought maybe you reacted to seeing the 77 truck up there. He got on the outside and he twitched a little. I thought maybe you reacted to that and cut down a little. And I thought Pearson saw it and reacted by trying to jump in the gas and drive by, thinking that maybe Pearson or McCune was going to turn left, and he didn't want to get caught in that. And when he did, the nose of that truck slid out just a little bit under power, and it was a racing deal. And I know you don't harbor any hard feelings, and I'm sure he don't. He just doesn't like to wreck them. That's just kind of the way it is.
No, and that's what I'm saying. He was apologizing to me, and I just wanted him to know that no hard feelings, and I feel it was just as much me as anybody. So, but I really appreciate you guys doing this. It's a lot of fun.
And we're in California next week, right?
Yes, sir.
That'll be interesting. That'll be the first time to see a lot of these guys. I bet you can see that track be when we come here next week. So that'll be an interesting race. It's big. It's fast. It's really kind of a one groove place, but it's kind of bumpy. It's going to make for some exciting racing if everybody gets a set right and everybody gets a handle on the track, I think.
Yeah, they had eight cautions tonight, eight lead changes amongst four drivers. Doug Lemon's leading the most laps with 73. Brandon leading 33 laps, Danny McCune leading 8 laps, and rightfully so, bringing home the last one to bring home the win here tonight, and David Lowe leading 1 lap. So, very interesting race. 8 cautions, might have been a little, extreme on the cautions, but a lot of it we've seen here tonight, Roger, was just slips, guys slipping. We didn't see anybody like totally, taking somebody out of the race, So, pretty good race, though. Not bad. So,
we saw several incidents that started as a self-spin and ended up collecting a couple of guys. It's just, it's a product of this track. It's a product of the weather conditions we were in. And it's just, when guys are going to race hard, that's what you're going to get. And we get really good hard racing over here every Sunday night. And I didn't hear anybody complaining. I didn't hear guys getting after each other tonight on the race chatter. So, I think everybody understands short track racing, man. You're going to bump and grind a little bit, and sometimes it doesn't go your way, and sometimes you get all the breaks. And it was a great race. I had a lot of fun watching it. I don't necessarily look forward to coming back here anytime soon. No offense, but this place can produce some fun, good racing. Some nights it produces some really, really bad. You ride around under caution racing. So I think we got the best of both tonight, really.
Absolutely. All right, well, that'll wrap it up here tonight for Midnight Motorsports from Richmond. Next week we'll see you at California Motor Speedway. I believe that's how it's pronounced. We will see you then, and signing off here from Max Speed TV.